The Tao of Self-Confidence, Episode 763.
Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to The Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have an amazing lady on the show today. She is a world traveler that made her dreams come true, and I'm really excited to have her on and share her story with us today on self-confidence. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Jackie Ung. Jackie, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more by yourself to the listeners.
I'm doing well. Thank you for having me, Sheena. I started my journey, I think, late in high school. My parents started taking me traveling around the world, and I got a taste of my passion through seeing different cultures, learning about different people. And I made that into a reality once I started working in my early 20s, where I started my travel blog. And since then, I've traveled to over 55 countries, which I think helps continually build my confidence as well as give back.
Thanks for sharing that. And Jackie, what's your cultural background?
Taiwanese, Chinese, American.
Thanks for sharing that. And in your own words, how do you define self-confidence?
I think there's two parts to it. I think one is being comfortable in your own skin, knowing exactly what you want and going about it no matter what society or your culture or your family says. And I think the second part is just knowing that you can overcome anything. At any time of difficulties, you feel confident in yourself, that you believe that you can conquer it without having too much self-doubt.
Thanks for sharing that great definition. I like how you mentioned, you know, knowing that you can overcome anything, because I think, you know, as women, especially Asian women, we feel like we're always defeated. But honestly, if we just keep, you know, moving forward, we know we can overcome them. And yeah, sometimes it might take a while, but that's life, right? It's up and down. It's not linear. And things are going to come in our way that could deter us or, you know, have challenges. But in the end, like, we know enough that we can go out there and do it and overcome it and thrive. So thanks for sharing that great definition. And Jackie, what was your life like before you discovered self-confidence?
Well, I grew up in a very traditional Asian American immigrant family. My parents did the best they could to raise us in the best way they knew how, but it was very strict tiger parenting. To me, it was too much micromanaging. But as I said, they did what they thought was the best way to raise kids, especially in a new country. So I felt very suffocated and claustrophobic growing up because my every move was monitored. The only focus was on getting good grades, and getting good grades was just never my strong point. I mean, I wasn't that interested in school, but if I didn't get good grades, straight A's, then I wasn't really allowed to do anything else. So I felt very trapped. I didn't know myself. I was very shy. So it really wasn't until I was the age of 17 when my parents let go. Partially because the college applications were all in, and whatever happened at that point, you know, determined what they thought was my future, and also because I was going to soon move out. So that's when I really found myself, was when they let go, when they allowed me to explore. I mean, they didn't really allow, but it was just like no more control over me. And I got to meet people of every different ethnicity in Southern California, got to go off to college, I got to try different hobbies. And that's when I really started to build my self-confidence, when I felt free.
Thanks for sharing that. And I think that's something we all can relate, right? I mean, we've been taught all our lives to live this one way. And yeah, back then, you know, when our parents like moved to a different country, they only know how to, like, they only know what they've been taught too, right? So it's not like we can really blame them. And at the same time, you know, we're here, we realize, like, you know, their style of parenting may work back then, but it won't work now because, you know, with the like different circumstances, different eras, different generations. And we have to realize, like, you know, we cannot go out there and be who we are today. And like, what was that point in your life, especially, you know, traveling around the world? I mean, I'm sure as a woman, a lot of people probably ask you, aren't you afraid traveling to all these countries? You have no idea what's going on. And, you know, like, what was that aha moment that gave you that confidence to go out there and just travel the world?
I think it was from my first trip, a solo trip abroad. It was when I was 23 years old. I had been wanting to go to India for 2-3 years. I knew I was going to go, and many people said it's unsafe, blah, blah, blah. But I was determined, and I've always been that type. If I want to do something, I'm going to find a way to do it. So something as simple as I wanted a certain prom dress made. And my mom said, no, that's impossible, because she was able to sew dresses. But since she didn't like it, I found a lady nearby that made dresses out of her home. And I had a friend take me because I didn't have a car, and I got it made. So something as little as that to going to India. I started doing my research online for months, actually years leading to that trip. I contacted every solo female travel blogger that wrote about India, and we were in touch, and they gave me a lot of tips. So I finally went out early 2008 on my very first trip. Pretty much everyone around me said, you're going to get killed, you're going to get raped. My parents thought I was going into a war zone because they associated with the Middle East and Iraq. But I went, and I went for 3 weeks, and I think it really was like an aha moment that I can do this. And I had done my research, and I had talked to people that had gone. So I felt like assured that I was going to be okay. And if something really bad did happen, then it would kind of be like a weird freak accident.
Thanks for sharing that. And I love that, you know, you're able to share a story like this, because yeah, you know, I'm sure a lot of, like you mentioned, a lot of people thought you were crazy for going to India by yourself. But like you said, you did the research. It's not like you decided to go to India, you know, like you just jumped on it. You did the research, you asked every other female traveler that went there by themselves, and you know, you researched the places where, you know, it is safe to go and places that aren't safe to go, and you know, and then, like, you know, you're able to do it and just show them what's possible. I mean, of course, you know, when we do something that's out of the ordinary, people are always gonna say something, right? I mean, sometimes it's out of love, sometimes they just don't believe you, but in the end, it's up to you to make it happen, whether you know, they listen to you now, or whether they laugh at you or not. And you did it. And, you know, that led you to traveling to over 55 countries, right? And because of that realization, what's your life been like now?
It's great. I feel like I've always been a happy person, but I become happier with age and more confidence that I build. It's amazing. I mean, I still go back to India. I've been 5 times. It's almost an annual tradition. I go a lot to the Middle East, which is a place that's even scarier for people because the media obviously feeds off negativity. They get people to glue their eyes on it more when they're saying, look at this place, it's so dangerous, they're doing this to people. So instead of saying, hey, a baby was born here in Iraq or in Iran. So I continually go to places that I'm drawn to culturally, but I'm also blogging about it because I want to encourage other people to go if they feel, you know, they're drawn to it. I went to Iran in July this year for 2 weeks. I was in Lebanon in June. So I continually go places despite what people that have not gone said. And it really, it brings true joy to my heart when I meet different people from different places, especially these places that are misunderstood and have such bad media. And the more I can give back through my blog and my audience, and I see friends of mine or audiences go and tell me, hey, because of you, I went to Lebanon, because of you, I'm planning a trip to Iran or wherever it is. It could be Paris or it could be London. It makes me happy because I feel like it's bringing interconnectedness to this world that's kind of lacking still because of media and because of negativity or fear of different cultures and religion.
Thanks for sharing that. And I think that's great what you're doing, right? Bringing a more positive perspective on countries that you mentioned are misunderstood, because yeah, all we see is, you know, it's a war zone. Oh, you know, it's bad there for women, right? Women aren't treated with respect, like, especially in the Middle East, they always say that. But like, you went there and you're still here and you're sharing it, whether it's through podcasts, on your blog, on social media. And, you know, the more we can just share our stories and what we're doing, like, the more we can inspire others to realize, like, hey, maybe it's not as bad as most people say, right? Maybe, you know, there are some great things that are happening there. Like you mentioned, like, nobody talks about, oh, a baby was just born in Iran, right?
Right.
I mean, it's like, it's more like, oh, you have to cover yourself up or you're going to go to jail or something. I don't know, right? I probably just made that up. But like, it's always like something negative, but like, you know, what you're doing is like the total opposite. And I think that's great. And especially like, you know, as a woman traveling, like, there's always so many stigmas about it, but you know, you're there, you're doing it, and you keep moving forward. And, you know, to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey to self-confidence. What'd be that tip you would give to her?
I think that the tip I would give, the very first step, is that if you know what you want out of life, it brings you a step there to confidence. But for those that are searching, or even those that know, I say, like, sit alone on a beach or even at home and envision yourself climbing a mountain or a hill, or even actually do it, like actually go climb a hill, either way, in your imagination or physically doing it, and reach that top of the hill and look out and imagine exactly what your life would be like if it was exactly how you wanted it, right? Imagine whether it's you want to be a mother of three and you want to be the best mom ever, or you want to be a CEO, or you want to be a world traveler, whatever it is, imagine it instead of just imagining yourself climbing. Like, imagine you've made it and exactly what it would look like. And once you have that clear vision, you know, hold on to that for a bit, meditate on that. And then afterwards, write it down. I think that anytime I've written down things, whether it's a simple to-do list or it's a big dream, like I want to have three kids and be the best mom, or I want to travel to 50 countries. When you write it down, it seems to come true more for whatever reason. Some people say because you're putting out to the universe. Some people say it's because you're holding yourself accountable. But once you know what you want, I think do what it takes to get there. If there's naysayers, even if it's family members, either you have to alienate yourself or you just have to know that this is what you want and you can go after it. Because I think that there's nothing more to build self-confidence than knowing that you can achieve it. And there's just so much cultural and societal pressure around that's not always bad. It's people sometimes just watching out for what they think is best. But I say just don't let anybody stop you from it, whether it's family, spouses, friends, or anything.
Thanks for sharing those great tips. And, you know, I don't think a lot of people realize, like, everything that's been created in this world started with someone's imagination. So, you know, our imagination is very powerful because what we imagine can also manifest in real life. So I really love that tip that you mentioned. And if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do and check out some of your travels, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Yes, my blog is bohemianvagabond.com and my Instagram is also bohemianvagabond. And through there, you can see two of my YouTube channels with a lot of travel videos. I have two videos up from Iran, which is, I think, very exciting. I went with another, she was a travel blogger from the Philippines originally. So yeah, everything's on there.
Thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Jackie, you can also head on over to the TaoofSelfConfidence.com and search for Jackie's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else that we talked about. And I really just want to thank Jackie today for taking the time to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Jackie.
Thank you for having me.
Not a problem. It was really great having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of Another Amazing Woman's Journey to Self-Confidence. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Get your free audiobook by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.